Well, this is a surprise.
It's a compliment, Kupski. I only got back this morning.
Maria Ivanovna.
Oh, hello. What have you been doing since I've been away?
Been bored, as usual, by Michael. Do sit down.
Thanks. But I'm dining with Victor Sabli. Only he doesn't know it yet.
Maria.
Victor.
Oh, I'm so glad to see you. Sit down here, won't you, please?
Thanks.
Well, what have you been doing? Who have you seen?
Oh, wait a minute, not so fast.
Well, I can't help it. There's so many things I want to tell you. But first tell me, where have you been?
In Moscow, studying chemistry. And you? I left you right here just about a year ago. You've been here ever since?
Practically. Almost every evening.
Doing what?
Hoping that you'd come in.
Now.
I mean it. I can't begin to tell you how I've missed you. Why did you run away? Why did you disappear like that? We were such good friends.
Perhaps I ran away because we were such good friends.
How is that common sense?
Oh, let's not talk about that. Tell me about you. What about your work? What progress have you made?
Not much, I'm afraid. I haven't had much heart for work.
I see.
No, I take it only in moderation. It's just that I've lost interest in everything.
Well, you abandoned the work after all your enthusiasm. Oh, I'm disappointed, Victor. I thought the thousands of Russians dying of tuberculosis would mean much more to you than any girl.
It isn't too late. I could pick it up right where I left off, with your help. You were always the only one who really believed in what I was doing, and I need an assistant.
There's nothing I'd love more than to work with you. Oh, but I couldn't.
Why?
It would only end up the same way.
Maria, listen to me. I realize, as soon as you went away, that I was really in love with you. And I made up my mind then that if we ever met, I'd tell you something. Well, we have met. And I'm going to say it. Will you marry me?
But you have your people to think about. Your father has a title. Mine has a little shop. It just wouldn't work out.
Well, you're not afraid that the difference in our rank
might... It isn't only that. I have a great affection for you, Victor. But it isn't love.
See. Then the real reason you went away was that you were afraid I was growing to love you, and you didn't love me, and you didn't want to hurt me.
I wonder. I don't think I know what love is. I may never know.
But how can you tell? Won't you marry me?
Oh, it would be too uneven a bargain.
What wouldn't be if I was perfectly contented with only your friendship? Now look, you studied chemistry. Why? Because you were interested in my work. Well, who in all the world could help me more than my wife? Our marriage need be nothing more than, well, how shall we say it, a scientific union. Well, at least it would be an interesting experiment.
If I thought there was a hope of falling in love with you...
I'm willing to take that risk. I swear I'll make you happy.
Maria!
Maria, where are you?
Here, Victor, here I am.
Come quickly.
What is it, dear? What is it?
I've succeeded.
Victor.
Look for yourself. See them with your own eyes.
Living germs. That means...
The most important part of the work is over. And the next step, I'll have the serum. And then in a few weeks...
Oh, help for all the sufferers. Oh, I'm so proud of you, Victor.
Oh, and I'm proud of you. I couldn't have done it without the help of my wife. Well, even the scoffers will have to admit our success now. And we'll share it equally.
I beg your pardon, for this person here.
Lieutenant Victor Sablin?
Yes.
Order, sir.
go now.
I must.
But what you're doing is so much more important, Victor.
We're dealing with soldiers now. I'm part of General Platov's army. Part of his machine for the taking of lives. What possible interest could a serum for the saving of lives have for a man like that?
But there must be some authority in Russia to recognize what you're doing.
They'd think it was a trick to evade service.
You've got to have time for your work. I'll go to General Platov myself. I'll go now.
Sons and husbands, just at the very moment they could not be spared.
General, I've only been married 3 weeks.
Perhaps you're lucky.
General, I'm sure there's some understanding about this thing.
No. Every time I've turned around today, some farming woman has popped up from somewhere, and I've given them all the same answer.
General Platov.
I'm not interested.
An extraordinary case.
Yes, they all are.
I don't ask for a release from my husband, just a leave of absence.
That's original.
He's a scientist, and he's just about
to... Not the scientific department.
He's under your command, and he's already gone.
Glad to hear it. Ah, Colonel.
You're excellent, sir.
Glad to see you.
But he'll be so much more use to Russia here.
Don't bother to turn on the tears. I want all the men I can get, and I mean to have them.
Where to, Excellency?
Hades. No, home. Too many women in Hades.
Bookworm. I said bookworm.
Interesting idea for a preventative serum.
What is?
Hookworm.
Do you think in diseases? Why not a serum to induce some sense of humor?
I think I need one, sharing a dugout with you.
Well, then share a little of the talk.
All right. What do you want to talk about?
Women. Women in general and wives in particular.
There isn't another girl in all the world like my wife. She's the most...
I know. Let's talk about mine. I almost wish she wasn't so darn pretty. I'm so far away. It's the uncertainty that drives me mad. I wish I knew what she was doing and whom she was with. But I will know. I know people that'll tell me. I'll write to them.
Lieutenant Stablin?
Yes?
General Platov's compliments. Report to General Headquarters at once.
All right.
Oh, but I can't. I've got to check out the ammunition train.
It's already gone, sir, under the general's orders.
All right. What a fool I am.
It's those infernal books.
How can I make a good soldier when my mind's on more important things?
You'd better not admit that to the general. To him, the army comes first, and always will.
Of course, I am guilty.
Of course. Now admit it at once. And listen to everything he says, politely. And thank him for any little present he may want to give you.
His case is simple, sir. He's drunk.
Obviously.
But what puzzles me is how he can do it on a sub-lieutenant's pay. Report to your quarters until further orders.
Lieutenant Rubinov, 1st Dragoon Regiment, overstaying leave. He's the fellow you saw jumping out of the window last night.
A lady. Is there any complaint about his military service?
None, sir. He's a good soldier, barring this neglect of duty. It's the second time.
We can afford to be lenient to a good soldier.
even though it be a second offense. But let there be no third. I am not partial to third offenders.
Thank you, Excellency.
And this, sir, is Lieutenant...
Yes. I'll attend to this. Lieutenant...
Sublin, sir. 3rd Infantry Regiment, 3rd Company.
Oh, you are in my army. I had some vague idea that you just dropped in casually, thinking this was a picnic, a sort of literary frolic.
I admit, sir, I've been guilty of negligence.
He admits it. An honest man. Or a clever one.
I forgot where I was, sir, absolutely. I was reading something so absorbing...
The Manual of Arms, of course.
No, sir. It was a statistical treatise on the absorption of antitoxins by the blood.
I hope to give you some blood to study it firsthand very soon. This is the third time you have neglected orders. You have received a reprimand and a warning. Now you must be taught a lesson. First, no more books of any kind.
I understand, sir. But I wonder if you do.
Be careful.
What sort of a lesson can teach me not to think? Why not face the fact that I cannot be a good officer when I know that my real value to Russia lies at home in my laboratory?
I agree with you on one point. As an officer, you are worse than useless. But you can and will be made into a good soldier. Captain Sabaki. This man has lost all right to his rank. His epaulets.
This is unjust, sir. I will appeal.
And perhaps you would prefer to keep them. Face a firing squad, a court-martial. That would be the proper procedure. Sergeant, here's some second-hand material for a soldier. Do what you can with it.
Yes, Excellency.
Regret your attitude of yesterday?
I regret nothing. Except that yesterday I treated you with too much respect. Shut your mouth.
No. Apparently we are about to hear how we should run our army.
Your army doesn't interest me. Do you think you can earn my respect with all this? Don't you suppose I thought and judged you when I was shoveling garbage all last night? And this morning when I dug that interminable trench? And now that I'm sweeping your floor? If you had any judgment, any intelligence, you'd see for yourself that every man can't serve his country as you do.
Sedition.
If sedition is speaking the truth as one sees it...
Yes, if one looks at it through a coward's eyes.
If it takes cowardice to be afraid of you, I'm not a coward. Every word that you say makes me despise you more. A beast trained in a heartless machine and set up in judgment over men with hearts and souls and ambition. It's a farce!
Arrest him. Solitary confinement.
Sergeant! Arrest this man. Solitary confinement.
It happened only 24 hours ago. He was court-martialed and sentenced to be shot. At noon, on the seventh day.
Then now... Now there are only 6 days between him and... Oh, can't you do anything here?
I can get your permission to go to Kovel. That's all. General Platov is still your only hope. The case against Victor is his, and only he can grant a pardon.
Oh, of course I'll go. You see, it's taken this terrible thing to show me how much Victor means to me. Well, General Platov cannot be touched by tears. There'll be no tears this time. Anna! When's the next train?
Madame Sablin, eh? Very well, this way.
leave it here. Keep your eye on it. Sergeant, for some lead.
Maria.
Oh, I've wanted to see you so much.
Oh, darling.
How did you know?
Olaf, I came as soon as I heard.
That was like you. Well, you see how it's all ended.
It hasn't ended.
What can you do to this machine that I'm caught in?
Throw in a monkey wrench if I can. If you could recant those things you said.
No. It would only make him despise me more. Let him keep his philosophy. He won't frighten me out of mine.
Then you'll imagine you're in the Imperial Opera House in St. Petersburg.
That is, of course, if you have good imagination.
Be better, Pat.
Wait till you see the
evening. I telegraphed for a room, Madame Sablin.
Well, it's waiting for you.
Is that a restaurant next door?
Well, they have food there. I don't think you'd like it. It's no place for a lady.
Well, I just thought I saw General Platov going in.
All the officers go there. Prima donnas can't sing, the chorus girls can't dance. Identity papers.
Will you announce me to your mistress, please?
Oh, no, I wouldn't dare. Before 12 in the morning, I never go near her unless she rings.
But I must see her at once.
Mm.
Just as an exception.
Oh, but I wouldn't dare announce you. She's that quick with a hairbrush. But I was just thinking, if you'd like to go up yourself, she's the first door on the right.
Come in, Nash, at your peril. For once, I'm glad you're here, you wet-nosed wench. You go right down and tell that cook that since I'm not running a dog show, I expect something better for breakfast than dog biscuits. You come back and clean up these ashtrays. Bring a wheelbarrow.
I beg your pardon, but I'm not your maid.
Ooh.
Can I give you a start?
A start? A finish? It'll settle down.
Your heart?
No, my floating rib. Don't you ever let one get loose.
Oh, it was very stupid of me. I...
Say, who are you anyway, and what do you want, and how did you get here?
Oh, I slipped past your maid.
Slipped? You won't get married this year. Oh, j'adore ça, j'adore ça.
Are you interested in earning 100 rubles?
Money?
Me?
Oh, no.
I want to buy your background.
Well, I have been told my back is rather fine. No, j'adore ça, j'adore ça. What are you saying about money? Oh, you know, one lady can always recognize another lady. And here I've kept you standing. Throw that rag off the chair and sit down. You know my name, of course. Alexandra Stroganoff. You don't mind if I continue this wrestling match with woman's crowning glory, do you?
I'll come straight to the point. My bargain includes silence and discretion. So shall we make it 100 rubles?
100 rubles? Remember my floating rib.
I want to meet somebody here.
What?
As an entertainer in your cabaret.
Oh! Now, dearie, you're not going to try to keep his identity a secret, are you? Oh, he's just sweet and curious. I'm so darn curious. You better tell me.
I'll find out anyway.
It's General Platov.
Well, I'll be shot.
I know he came here last night. Does he come often?
Yes. But I don't know why.
My motive must be my secret.
Mm-hmm.
May I say it? It's just a sort of joke.
Yes, you can say it. In fact, I think it's a good idea. You know, the general hasn't fallen for any of my talent up to now. But even without the money, I'd love to help you. Oh, je suis une entregante, to say. You know, I think perhaps I'd feel more sure the joke was on the general if I was paid in advance. Can you sing?
A little.
Well, go on, let's hear the words.
Oh, I need you so. Why did you go and leave me waiting here alone? All I dream about, all I want, is just to hear you say, I love you.
Yeah, that ought to cost you 200 rubles. However, you can't make a success here and be a lady. Have you an entertainer's costume?
Well, I'm afraid not.
I could rent you almost anything, but of course it would be extra. Oh, but what does that matter to a lady like you? One with the uttermost sans souci. Just open that cupboard door, will you? You know, I can't touch my feet to the floor before 12 o'clock. It makes me so nervous.
Oh, my little baby. Cuckoo, cuckoo, cuckoo. I think that lovely white net number with a bit of fur. Celia, Celia, this is my little cousin, Carmina. You know, when it comes to handling money, give me a woman every time. I trust no man until I see him with a lily on his chest. Ah, good evening, gentlemen. Carmina, girls. This is my little cousin, Carmina. Oh, don't eat so much. You're so fat now. Carmina. This is my little cousin, Carmina.
Well, how do you do?
Hey, music. Come on. Music. Of course, I speak metaphorically, but I call it music. I'm too much of a lady to say what you really are after that bill you handed out last night.
You like something in a lighter vein?
I don't care anything about veins. It's tunes I'm after. Oh, j'adore, j'adore. Oh, gentlemen.
This. Hello, little mother.
Hello, mother. Optimist. Hello? You seem rather happy again.
Just a little reminiscent of last night.
Naughty, naughty, naughty. Oh, this is my little cousin Carmina. Oh, two adorable wretches. You know, little Carmina hasn't had time to rehearse as yet, so I'll leave her in your hands.
One Imperial for number one.
Well, Alexandria is certainly right. You are in the Imperial class.
He certainly is.
The very best champagne.
He would, always the same. So, you don't like compliments, eh? Well, you're a new kind of girl to me. And I'm very partial to novelties.
Really?
You know the old saying, an eye for an eye. Well, why not a shoulder for a soldier?
Oh, no, no, no. You must confess. Oh, but darling, there are two of you, and I must be fair.
But you've got two shoulders.
Right.
I'm a detective. She's expecting someone.
Oh, no.
With us here? Why, who's the worst expecting?
I wonder. But you know, it's my first night here, and I must see you all before I can...
Very sensible, too, my dear. Now, why should a delightful girl like you have to listen to the twaddle
well,
of a mere...
the most twaddle? This shoulder and shoulder business is enough to make any girl sick.
But do you realize that you're speaking to your superior officer?
Yes, sir, in the army, but in love, I'm a general.
Oh, listen to the cockle crow.
No, no, please, don't stop it.
You ought to be flattered. I was introduced to her
we
first.
We were introduced...
Sometime tomorrow and begin a new lair.
And don't forget my commission. I did pretty good on the wine tonight.
All right, all
night.
Right. Good night. Well, no use burning holes in daylight. Well, what's to be done with him? Leave him where he is, the beast. He ought to go somewhere. But he's too gone to go. Didn't show up tonight, did he? Perhaps tomorrow night.
Do you think just hoping he's going to carry me through another night like this? Poor old an animal. No. I can't afford to take any more chances. I must be sure he'll be here next time.
baby.
Hello.
Is the general inside?
No.
He's not liable to come along and see me, is he?
No. He ain't expected for 10 minutes.
Oh.
But I'll be relieved before him and his staff of rummies comes in from inspection to eat.
Hey, you, what do you mean by that? You've got a nerve.
Oh, don't be angry. I could be shot for that.
Well.
Well, this ain't no place for a little talk. See that bench over there?
Mm-hmm.
Will you wait for me there? 5 minutes?
For you, baby, 5 years.
Hey, sweetheart, I gotta be honest with you. I never got even a look from a dream like you before. Honest, I feel like it wasn't real.
Perhaps it isn't. Hey, you want to ruin my lip rouge?
It's on my diet. But say, we can't stay here.
No?
Old Iron Face may come along any minute now.
Oh, this is the way he comes in.
Yeah.
Hey!
How about a little stroll in them there woods?
No, thanks. Not in those slippers.
We need to walk so very far.
Why walk at all? What do we care for Iron Face? You're not on duty. Come on, baby. Stop it! Help! Help! Stop it! Help! 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 Oh, he kissed me, that beast! He dared to kiss me! One of your soldiers, too! At least you are officers, I suppose.
Now, speaking to General Plattoff.
Well, you look almost human.
Well, since I've made such a pleasant impression, I think it behooves me to move on.
Oh, no, you don't. I'm not going to stay here alone. That soldier might be lurking in any bush.
There aren't so many. He couldn't be lurking behind them all.
One would be quite enough, thank you. After the training he seems to have gotten in your army.
Captain Gogo. You will take this young lady behind you.
Yes, sir.
No, thanks. I don't like the way he said that. In fact, they all look a little too anxious. I'd rather walk. Isn't there one man in this army a girl can really trust?
I'm sure I don't know.
I do. You. I'll bet you've never looked at a girl more than 3 times.
You're flattering me.
Well, of course I'm flattering you. I want protection. Good night. Couldn't I just walk along beside you? I really am frightened.
Right on in front. Tell him to keep things hot for me.
Keep things hot for you, you'll make things pretty hot for them. Well, I've heard all about you.
Oh?
They call you Iron Face. You're not quite human because you have no heart. You're just a bit of military machinery. Been a soldier all your life, I suppose. But I bet you were never quite like that soldier on the bench.
I trust not.
Seems a pity. You missed a lot. I said you missed a lot.
Missed a lot of impertinence to judge by the present conversation.
Ooh, is it a conversation? I thought I was doing all the talking.
What were you doing with that soldier on the bench?
What would you say if I told you I picked him up, made him kiss me, just for the sake of meeting you?
Certainly ask if you thought me quite a fool.
I didn't think you believed me. Well, this is far enough, thank you.
Thank you ever so much.
Not yet. I intend to take you home.
Must be awful to have to be so dignified. You know, you're the most mysterious man. Sometimes you seem so... And then again, sometimes you don't.
Well, you're not exactly like other young ladies that I have met.
Oh, there's nothing mysterious about me. I spend a great deal of my time here. That is in the evening. I sing when there's no other comic number on the program. Thanks again. See you somewhere, Iron Face.
But they didn't have to open my veins to see that my blood was blue.
I'm sure they know.
You know, even while the butler was scraping the caviar off my back, I still remembered that I was the chatelaine of a palace.
That was all right. Thing.
And I drew myself up to my full height, and I said, "You dirty, jelly-fingered shrimp. What do you think I am? A slice of lemon?" Now I ask you, was that cause for a divorce?
No. I'm not myself.
Oh, well, if it hadn't happened, I wouldn't have gone to Paris. Mm. Dear old Paris. And if I hadn't gone to Paris, I wouldn't have been here.
Voilà,
c'est la vie. Could express my feelings. This is the night of nights. It needed only your excellency to cap the climax. To course of imperial.
The climax is rather funereal. At your ease, gentlemen.
Oh, you're neglecting me.
Noise.
You see, you have only to speak. I suppose you call that a dignified exhibition. Everybody enjoying themselves. Everybody having
a good time. Then in you walk the ghost of old man War himself, and boom, we're in a graveyard. You'll find he has nothing up his sleeve, ladies and gentlemen, only a wet blanket hidden under his coat.
Laugh, gentlemen. I'm sure it's all most amusing.
Go ahead, laugh!
Go on with the music. I don't mind.
That's right, sing!
Sit down. Well, you're here to entertain? Entertain me.
I haven't rehearsed yet.
You don't need any rehearsal as far as I'm concerned.
Well, if I must.
Sit down. And feel yourself honored.
If you dislike me so, what'd you come here to see me for?
That's good. I came here to see you.
Oh, you can't fool me. I know what brought you here.
Well, suppose you did. No reason I should stay.
Now you sit down. You great big bully. Come on. Come on, come on.
What's your name?
Carmina. Got any objections to that? Since he came in.
Yes, dear. Well, he goes someplace else or we go bankrupt.
What are you thinking about?
You? I'm sorry to say. You know, if you're just a born bully, there's nothing to be done about it. Of course, if it's just acquired.
What would you do about it, Miss Carmina?
I'm not quite sure. Mr. General?
Why not Iron Face?
It seems to have melted a little.
You seem a bit softer yourself. Headache?
No, a little.
All the air in these cabarets could be concentrated to make the most deadly gas in the world.
Oh, sure, General. Are you quite comfortable? How about one of the private rooms upstairs?
Shall we leave that to Carmina?
Would it be absurd if we went for a walk?
A walk?
A walk?
A walk.
All right, a walk.
Get a wrap.
No, no. Wear my coat.
You'll be cold.
No, not tonight.
I'll take bets on who's running the army now.
Then
My good woman, you're getting to be a jack-in-the-box.
What else can I do but wait and try and see you like this? Oh, can't you help me, miss? He won't listen.
Get out of my way.
I've given you 3 sons. Isn't that enough? Boris is all I've got left in the world.
Oh, please, can't you help
no.
us?
No. Am I the only man in Russia who is willing to fight?
Are you really cruel?
Why should I explain myself to you? I thought we came out for a walk. Come on. Sit down. Come on now, confess. Did you ever think you'd be lucky enough to be walking out like servant girls do with a general of the Russian army?
Well, I certainly never thought I'd be lucky enough to be out walking with a general of the Russian army like a policeman.
Hey, what's the matter with you and me? If we can't be civil, let's go home.
Go ahead, go ahead. I'm not stopping you. Don't do that.
I thought that's why walks in the moonlight were invented.
Perhaps they are. I don't know. Go ahead. Do it again if you want to. I don't mind. Go on.
Oh, thanks.
Well, I'm sorry, but a girl like me isn't used to lovemaking like that.
For the moment, I thought you were different. Why I should have thought so, I don't know.
Look at the moon.
I've seen the moon. I'd like to see it shine in your eyes, though.
You know, a little later, all those mountains will be covered with snow.
Yes, and cold as you are.
I'm not cold. I've got your coat.
You know, that's not what I mean. It's a pretty evening's work, this is. I can't even make love to you.
Ooh, do you want to?
You think I came out for a friendly chat? Come on now. Be honest, for once.
All right. I did want you to make love to me at first. Very much. Now, all of a sudden, I don't.
Well, if you're not the most exasperating, incredible...
I wouldn't be flattered to have you make love to me. But don't you see, it would be a catastrophe if I should fall in love with you.
You wretched, adorable little...
Oh, no. I won't be serious. I won't even play at it.
Well, we've got to play at something.
All right. Then it would be something absolutely childish and absurd. I know. Seesaw.
Seesaw?
Mm-hmm.
Why, seesaw?
Oh, just because there's no reason for it. Come on.
Well, I suppose you being a woman, seesaw, carries the day.
I'll have to be longer on my side, you know. Come on. That's right. Wait now, hold it steady. Look out. I'm caught. There. All right?
Your moon is responsible for this madness.
Oh, don't look so solemn.
Solemn? Why shouldn't I look solemn? I meet a girl this morning and I want to slap her. Tonight I go to a filthy cafe to meet her. There I move to strangle her. Now I'm out in the moonlight playing seesaw with her. Is that common sense?
No.
To go into that madhouse tonight.
Oh, no. I couldn't.
I'm glad. I hate to say goodnight to you. Hanged if I'm not afraid you'll be someone else in the morning. You know,
You're like one of those things I used to have when I was a child. You held it up before your eyes, turned it around, and
the pattern was never quite the same.
Then you didn't like the girl I was this morning?
Well, there must have been something about her that I liked.
Girls have to act that way sometimes.
Why are you at Alexander's? I know you're not her cousin, and you're too fine to be even her friend.
Because there's someone quite helpless depending on me.
No, I'm such a clumsy fool at saying things.
Oh, don't say anything more. It's been perfect.
That's not quite worthy of how I feel.
Good night.
Good night.
What is the name of that woman that's been bothering me about her son?
Boris Pavlov, sir.
Oh, yes, Boris Pavlov. I should remember by this time. Private, 3rd Infantry Regiment, 4th Company. Send that out first thing in the morning.
Who is it?
Nicodok, chérie.
Let me in. And where are you going at 3 o'clock in the afternoon when you ought to be taking your beauty sleep?
Just out.
Out?
Oh, what beauty.
I just wanted to find out how things were before I ordered the dinner. You know, if old Iron Face is in this mood, he won't argue about a dinner check.
He won't have to. I'm not going. I've just written to tell him so.
Have you sent the note?
No.
Oh, Daddy.
But I will.
Well, as long as I've been in the show business, I've never seen anything like this before. C'est une grande nouveauté, and that's no mistake. Oh, I've seen girls fall in love with the men they went after. But I never saw one try to run away after she got him.
Oh, don't be stupid. I don't want to run away, and I'm not in love with General Platov.
A very good speech, my dear, but it does not go down with me. I've lived, dearie. And if you refuse this invitation, caring the way you do, why, c'est une disaster. You know, I may not be the accepted idea of Cupid, but you must change your mind. Oh, your heart's on my side. Well, anyway, I can't afford to lose the business. Now, you have only to write one teeny little word. Yes. Now, come on. Come on. Come on, sit down. There. Yes. Yes.
You know that there's no hope anywhere, and you're afraid to tell me?
Oh, no.
There's something you're afraid to tell me.
Or are you ashamed?
Victor.
Oh, my darling, I'm sorry. But when you're alone like this, tell me, what have you done here? What is your plan?
What could it be except to try and reach General Plattdorf some way?
You're wasting your time there. You told me how he treated you before. If he could understand, I wouldn't be here.
But some of his officers, they're close to him. Perhaps they could succeed where I failed.
Could any man influence Plattdorf?
Could any woman?
Look at me. Of what man are you thinking?
Well,
has any man promised to help you with Plattdorf?
No, no one.
But you think somebody might?
I don't know. Oh, darling. Darling, if there were someone, it would be fair, wouldn't it? Oh, surely to save you would justify any subterfuge.
What sort of subterfuge? My life must not be bought. It must be given to me, fairly.
Why should I be fair? Is your sentence fair?
Mario, if you're unfair to me, if you're unfair to yourself, I wouldn't want to live. We couldn't go on together. We made a bargain, but it was an honorable one. Mario, I want you to promise me to keep it so. Promise me.
I promise.
Another woman, but still Carmina. How many are there of you?
There's still another one. Inside me.
I wonder if we're both hiding secrets. Could they be the same?
I hope not.
I suppose my uniform hides the fact that I'm trembling all over because you're here. Between each mouthful of dinner tonight, I tried to think of something brilliant to say, but never succeeded. Is there any saner explanation for such carryings on than that I am in love?
Too much champagne.
No, no, I know that champagne feeling. No, this is something that I've never felt before. It makes me terribly happy and yet it makes me angry. It all seems so absurd.
Why should it be absurd?
Because it's only 36 hours since I first met you.
I think love is like a wave. If it comes on you unawares, nothing can stop it from sweeping over you. Of course, if you're a good swimmer.
Oh, I want to drown. Carmina. I love you. I wonder if you realize how much.
That's just what I'm wondering now. You see, I have a favor to ask you.
But is this favor so important?
I can't risk a refusal.
What if I offer in advance to grant it?
I don't want it that way.
Suppose I should ask you to marry me.
I didn't ask for proof as strong as that.
But I think of you that way. If I am the kind who loves only once, then this speech can be made only once.
Oh, Gregory. I never dreamed. No. It wouldn't be fair to you.
You mean the difference between us? Nonsense.
Why, socially we were as far apart as the pole.
There may be a new order of things. Whoever I choose to make my wife shall share my position.
Please. I can't say yes.
You ask me to prove my love, and yet you refuse it. What is this great favor?
I can't ask it now. I want to forget everything but ourselves. Surely I have the right to love for a little, without thought or reason or any shadow.
Carmina.
Oh, nothing matters but love. And mine is here in your arm. And it's yours. All my love.
My darling.
But darling, you've been crying. Surely you don't regret.
I regret nothing. You know I love you. Gregory, I've come about the favor I spoke of last night.
Oh, the favor, of course, dear. It was swept away in the waves.
No, but I couldn't ask it then. I could only think of my love for you. This morning, I know I must.
But why be so tragic about it? What could you possibly ask that I would refuse? What is it?
I want the life of Lieutenant Victor Sabling. His pardon.
What is this Sabling to you?
Just a man condemned to be shot today at noon.
Yes, I know, but why are you so interested? What is he to you?
Does that matter? You love me. Surely just for that you'll let him go. Oh, it's only my duty that makes me ask you.
What does he mean to you? What is this duty?
I'm his wife.
Yes, now I understand it all from the beginning on that dusty road. Just one more. Only cleverer than the rest.
Oh, no, you must. You mustn't think that. I admit, at first, it wasn't just a game. But last night, my love was real.
Don't make it any worse by pretending it wasn't just as false as the beginning. In it all, have you ever thought of me?
I've thought of you so much, it's made me a coward. I tell you, I put everything behind me when I let you take me in your arms.
The last trick of any woman.
Oh, no, no, you mustn't think that. That was for you, because I loved you. Oh, can't you understand how one may give her heart to one man and still be loyal to another?
All I can understand is that her wife loved her husband so much she was willing to play any game to save him.
I never loved him, not really as I love you.
Don't make me despise you anymore.
Well, you've succeeded in one thing. If Lieutenant Sadley never had a chance, he has lost it now. Any man deserves to die who would use his wife as he has used you.
Heaven, he doesn't know.
And you've cheated us both. Go on, get out.
Gregory!
Get out!
Why don't you read it? But it's... I'm free! From... General Platoff.
Yes.
From General Platoff.
Hello, Jailbird. Glad to see you back. There's a report that the general's expecting an attack. Thought you might...
I think my wife has done what you were afraid of for your wife. At least...
But you don't know. Oh, that's the torture. You've been through one inferno in jail, and I'll be hanged if I see you go through another. You're too good for her, that's all.
You know something about Maria.
Maria? They called her Carmina there. At Alexander's Cafe. Of course, she wasn't dressed like that. It took me 2 evenings before I recognized her. The first, she and her man got up and went out for a walk. Second, they went up to a private room for dinner.
You saw the man?
Of course I saw him.
Who was he?
What difference does it make as long as he was there?
None. I just want to kill him, that's all.
Kill him?
Who was the man?
Well, I'll not tell you. I thought I was doing you a favor. I'm not going to put a rope around your neck.
Jules, tell me your answer!
Tell me. Lieutenant Glinker, 3rd Company, 3rd Infantry. Quiet. What?
Who was the man?
The general's coming down on trench inspection.
Was the man you saw with Maria on the general's staff?
Why pick on that collection?
Attention!
Attention! Attention! Attention!
Who gave me my pardon?
General Platoff, of course.
Oh, he signed it. But what man around him has enough influence to make him change his mind?
Inspection is not just a formality. I want to complete...
please report on every condition.
I will remain in this sector for at least an hour.
Lieutenant Blinker, your dugout will be my headquarters. Lieutenant Blinker, order a barbed wire inspection at once. Colonel, go over the telephone system. Take Captain Sabakin with you.
Yes, sir.
I have a special mission for Lieutenant Sablin. Here is a transfer from this regiment to the medical corps at St. Petersburg.
I haven't had a chance, sir, to thank you for
No. Don't thank me. Your pardon was due to someone who saw more clearly than I did.
That man was bought.
So a man influenced me. And he was bought.
My wife paid the bribe. Please, sir, I must stay here until I
can... That is my order. You have no further right here now.
I must find that man.
What for?
To kill him.
I am the man you're looking for. Send this to the repair shop. Control is too light. Lieutenant Sablin might have hurt himself badly. Get out.
You are braver than I thought. Perhaps in your place, I would have done the same.
I want to kill you. I want to kill you.
Would it surprise you to know that I wouldn't care?
Surprise attack. Save your life while you have it.
I don't want it. But not my pride.
Get off that off. One direction is the attack. Find Captain Sabakin and send him to be here at once. You tricked me, I wanted you to die. It's only my pride that forces me to send you back to her safely. You're alive and you'll please remain so.
Good evening, Anna.
Good evening, sir.
Victor.
You're going away.
What else could I do?
You needn't change your plans. Maria, are you glad or sorry?
How could I be anything but glad that you're safe?
In the last 3 weeks, you've made no inquiries for me.
I thought it was useless. I was afraid to know the truth.
We both know the truth now. I'm alive,
Because you broke your promise to me.
That promise was beyond my strength to keep.
I know who the man was, you know. I should have guessed it before he had to tell me.
Then he understood, after all. He released you.
He did more than that. Whatever his reason was for doing it all, doesn't matter. I can go back to my work now.
Here? Just as before?
No. How can anything be as it was before? What happiness can there be for us with the thought of that broken promise always between us? I'll make arrangements so that you can divorce me without any embarrassment to yourself.
Oh, don't think about me. I was so weak. I was crushed between the two of you. To be loyal, I had to be disloyal. To find love, I had to go where no love should have been.
It was all my fault from the beginning. How could affection and friendship ever take the place of love? You were right. It was an uneven bargain.
I assure you, madame, there was nothing wonderful about it. He was standing on top of the trench, unarmed. I only did what anyone else would have done.
Oh, no, no, I know how it happened. Victor told me. I just wanted to thank you myself, to tell you how humbly grateful I am.
Merely a gesture on my part, a wordless apology for my behavior the last time we met.
Oh, no, it was far more than that.
Wait.
Tell me this. Did his coming make you happy?
He only came to say goodbye.
Then he doesn't realize how fine you are, how loyal.
You didn't think I was fine or loyal, did you? You were both right. I loved you, but I was willing to use you. It wasn't only loyalty to Victor that sent me back to you that morning. It was shame.
Shame for making a human being out of a machine?
I didn't know that then.
Can there be any room for misunderstanding between us? Can misunderstanding ever separate you and me?
Not if you hold me very close.